and sand of the United States. And here are the 1992 British champions, Catherine Pritchard and Jason Briggs. They upset the six-time national champions, Peake and Naylor. Then came to the European Championships.
There are flowers on the ice.
And we have flowers on the ice, so they have asked Pritchard and Briggs to wait. And this will be unsettling for them in really their first major international competition.
It is. It's very unnerving to come out and be all ready to go and then suddenly have to stop. It really breaks your concentration.
Looks like Jason got some help, and they'll get that flower off the ice. Briggs is 20. He's from Mansfield in Nottinghamshire. Catherine's from North Shields.
On the ice.
And ironically, they upset Peake and Naylor at the British Championships and then finished four spots behind them at the Europeans, so I think that might add a little pressure to them now.
Well, Chris, I was surprised they didn't go back to the boards because they had the opportunity with that slight delay. They could have gone back to the boards, regained their thoughts, but they chose to just mull around out there, and we'll have to see if it's going to have any impact on this performance.
Skating to Blade Runner from Vangelis. The double axel earlier today in practice. The next element up, we'll see if they can do them. No. She just didn't quite look on top of her skate there on the landing.
One of the things that a lot of people quite often overlook about pair skating is that they say, why can't the pair skaters nail those double axels in the short program? But what a lot of people don't realize is that pair skaters not only have jumps to worry about, but they have lifts, death spirals, pair spins, side-by-side spins, split double twists. So you just can't dedicate as much time as you'd like to that one jump. And as a result, you're going to see a higher percentage of the missed in the short than you would, say, in the singles long program.
But I must say the quality of the single skating in the pairs event has come a long way, even since we were in this competition.
Oh, when we get to the long programs, we'll certainly see some big triple jumps from some of these pair teams. Up between these two skaters as they're out there, and that's one of the things the judges are looking for. You want to keep the space when you're solo skating to a minimum. Aside from the double axel, I think for them a good performance.
Like you said though, Paul, there were times when there was quite a bit of space between them. A few problems with unison here and there, and there wasn't quite the height on the twist that we're going to see a little bit later on. Actually, next up.
Isabel Brasseur and Lloyd Eisler waiting in the wings. In fact, they have just taken the ice as we watch a replay of Briggs and Pritchard.
The side-by-side double axel, she just is not rotating and centered over her right side the way she wanted to be, and not in a position to land it cleanly. This is again another team which, unfortunately, probably at home in their home rink, don't have a lot of other pair skaters to train with and push them along, and it's so important in a sport like this.
While you're watching this, Lloyd and Isabel are warming up at opposite ends of the rink. Is that how you used to warm up?
Well, in a situation like this, you are warmed up, but it's nice to get out there, get a feel for the way the ice is, see if it's changed since warm up, but in a flight of three, that's not likely to happen. And interestingly enough, Torvald Lundin, the great dancers, did the same thing. They would never skate together in a warm-up.
We have Ron McLean standing by behind the Kiss and Cry area. He'll talk to Isabel and Lloyd after their skate, and you can hear the crowd reaction to those low marks for Pritchard and Briggs. Clearly here for experience in their first international competition of this magnitude. And the marks from three sixes up to a 4-3 from the hospitable French judge. The Canadian judge is Dennis McFarlane. Judge number six.
Deuxième note.
Second set of marks are considerably higher, but we've had five pairs, and Pritchard and Briggs right now in fifth place. They were 13th and last at the European Championships in Lausanne.
Second mark, 4-7, 4-1, 4-2, 4-1.
Well, they don't seem too disappointed with those marks. And what a thrill just to be here.
Four, one.
Merci.
Thank you.
Well, here begins one of the